بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. As the past occurrences made us or broke us, am I still 50-50 or 100% on the road to finding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? As the saying goes, when you remember who you are, the game changes. When you remember who you are, the game changes. If we realize that we are the servants of Allah, we are the ummah of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sent with a great responsibility to save ourselves and our families and mankind from the eternal devastation and destruction of dunya and akhirat, then the game will change. Every moment, every second, every split second will be spent differently. After seeing this recent halat, just the nuksan of dunya, and the people of dunya will be worried about their dunya. The global economic bailout currently, this is CNN Business November article 2020, is running at $19.5 trillion. The current global economic bailout is running at $19.5 trillion. So nothing in our current lifetimes can be compared with the magnitude of the current COVID-19 disaster. If we have to go back in history, a comparable crisis and pandemic of this magnitude was the Spanish flu in 1918 by the H1N1 virus genes. About 500 million people, or one third of the world's population, were infected with the Spanish flu virus. And at least 50 million people perished around the world, 675,000 in the USA. So if we have to go back in history and look at the current situation, this should be sufficient for a revolution in a person's life. Otherwise, if that is not sufficient, then Quran is clear. فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ. We took each one of them, each one who rebelled against Allah, for the sin, for the crime, for the guna, for the evil that they committed. Quran is clear. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ حَاسِبًا. And there were those who we sent hurricanes. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَخَذَتْ هُسَّيْهَا. And there are those who were taken over by awful cry. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضِ. And those who the earth swallowed. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَغْرَقْنَا. And those who we drowned. Then Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ. When these conditions and halat and problems occur, remember, Allah has not done any wrong, any injustice to you. وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. This is by way of your very actions. The hurricane, according to Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, عَادْ مَنْ أَشَدُّ مِنَّا قُوَةٌ. An intense, violent, cold wind came and wiped them out, threw them headlong onto the ground. كَأَنَّهُمْ أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ خَاوِيَةٌ. Like uprooted stems of date palms. And the awful cry was to the people of Thamud. And the earth swallowed Qarun because he transgressed. He was arrogant. فَخَسَفْنَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sank him and his wealth and his property until Qiyamati will continue being sunk. And those that we drowned were Fir'aun, Haman and his troops. None of them escaped. Manatani Rahmullah used to say, when conditions, halat, trials and turbulence comes, there'll be two groups of people. Either the first group will get closer to Allah, they will gain close proximity to their Khaliq, and the second group will be distanced from Allah. They will go in more ma'asiyah, they will say words of kufr and shirk. Na'udhubillah, why? What did we do to deserve this? Some people say, what wrong did I do? Ulama say, you're supposed to say, what right did I ever do? What correct thing did I ever do in my life? So a person will increase ma'asiyat and sin. We can blame the New World Order and the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds of this world. When will I blame myself? Hazrat Nu'man bin Bashir radiallahu anhu was given a khutbah and he said, إِنَّ الْحَلَكَةَ كُلَّ الْحَلَكَةَ أَن تَعْمَلَ السَّيِّئَاتِ فِي زَمَانِ الْبَلَى. Destruction, total destruction to those people who do evil in sin and ma'asiyat when there is a calamity in a period of trials and tribulations, when difficulties, when fitna, when plague, when the signs of Allah in front of us, then destruction upon that person who increases his ma'asiyat and disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said about Anas bin Sirin that they were in Kufa and news came to them that Masruq used to flee from the plague. So Muhammad bin Sirin said, not possible. Let us go and inquire. So when we hear certain news, we don't just believe it, we verify it. فَلْنَسْأَلْهَا, let's go and ask his wife. فَأَسَأَلْنَاهَا أَنْ ذَلِكَ فَقَالَتْ كَلَّا. We inquired from her. She said, never. Wallah, مَا كَانَ يَفِرْن. He would never ever run from a plague. What's the true story? وَلَكِنَّهُ يَقُولْ أَيَّام تَشَاغُلْ. These are days where people are busy and getting themselves involved in other things. فَأُحِبُّ أَنْ أَخْلُوَ لِلْعِبَادَةِ. I rather prefer to be engaged in the worship of Allah than rather being preoccupied with dunya. So the wife saying that I choose to be with him when he used to go in solitude worshiping Allah, and I would cry because I would see how much he would engage himself in ibadah, how much dua, what salah, that his feet used to swell. And he used to say, the plague and disease and drowning, whoever dies of these will die of shahada. So we try in ibadah, and if it is a destiny for us, then we will die shahada. We will die in ibadah, or we will die in shahada. A doctor operating on a person, a surgeon, is not cutting the person up to harm him. The operation is to fix him. Allah is the master surgeon. Let us be happy with the decree of Allah and take lesson. When the operation is complete, you have a diet, you have a routine, you have medication, you have things which you need to abstain from. There are rules. A shepherd has a dog which looks after the sheep. At any occasion when the sheep or one of the sheep decide we will go on our own, then the shepherd releases the dog. The dog goes and attacks the sheep as if it is going to bite that sheep. In that fear, that sheep returns back. The dog nudges the sheep but doesn't bite the sheep. Initially, the sheep presumes that in its solitude there is sanctity, but in actual fact, there is destruction. And the dog has to be there to bring the sheep back to reality. When the servants of Allah move away, alaykum bil jama'ah, ashabika nujum, Nabi alayhi salam has left a clear-cut Quran and Hadith guidance in front of us. And when we depart from that highway, that sheep needs to be brought back. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتِ Allah is saying there are signs لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ Take lesson لِأُولِي النُّهَى لِأُولِي الْأَبْصَارِ Take lesson from the occurrences. Ibn Kathir Imullah explains الْأُقُولِ التَّامَ الذَّكِيَّةِ That intelligence that can fathom a lot of things should not be وَلَيْسُ فِيهِمْ تَصُمْ الْبُكْنُ الَّذِي لَا يَعْقِلُونَ They should not become deaf and dumb to what is happening around them. وَكَأَيِّمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَمُرُّونَ عَلَيْهَا وَهُمْ عَنْهَا مُعْرِضُونَ How many signs every day, every moment passing in front of us, the alan of the janazas. How many funerals have we been to? How much situations we've seen death in front of us? We've brushed with death. We've rubbed shoulders with death. Yaqulu Jalla wa Ala. Abu Ja'far says, وَكَمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لِلَّهِ وَعِبْرَةٌ وَحُجَّةٌ How many lessons and proofs have passed you and you still continue in this negligence? لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَسَسِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ There are lessons for the intelligent. This is detailed lessons. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has explained to us these lessons. لَوْلَا شُيُّخٌ رُكَّعٌ وَشَبَابٌ خُشَّعٌ وَأَتْفَالٌ رُضَّعٌ وَبَهَائِمُ رُتَّعٌ If it was not for the elderly bowing in front of Allah and the youth submitting to Allah and the suckling infants and the grazing animals لَصَبَّ عَلَيْكُمُ الْعَذَابَ صَبَّ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have flooded, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have rained azab upon azab upon azab. لَخَسَفَتْ بِكُمُ الْأَرْضِ خَسْفًا The earth would have swallowed you. وَلَمَنَعْتُكُمُ الْقَتَرْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ And not a single drop of water would have rained from the asman. Riwayat of Imam Ahmad. And it's mentioned in Madarij Salikin, a riwayah, مَا مِنْ يَوْمٍ إِلَّا وَالْبَحْرُ يَسْتَأْذِنُ رَبَّهُ أَيْ يُغْرِقَ إِبْنَ آدَمُ Every day, because of the flagrant violation of the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the oceans, the heavens, the earth have had enough. They say, Ya Allah, give us permission. Let us wipe out this insan. Wal malaika tasta'adhinuhu an tu'ajilahu wa tuhlikahu. Even the farishtas looking at the amal of insan says, Ya Allah, give us permission to destroy this insan, what a great Rabb, what a great Allah. How fortunate are we to have this Allah. What does Allah reply? وَالْرَبُّ Ta'ala yaqul da'u 'abdi, leave him alone, he is my servant, fa ana a'lamu bihi, I know him better than you, idh ansha'tuhu min al-ard, I created him from inception, in kana 'abdakum fa sha'nukum bihi, if he is your servant, if he is your slave, then you do as you desire. وَإِنْ كَانَ عَبْدِي فَمِنِّي وَإِلَيَّ عَبْدِي, but if he is my servant, then I will do as I deem fit. I will treat my servant as he deserves to be treated. And listen well, you are looking at him and you thinking he will not return. وَعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي, Allah takes an oath. إِنْ أَتَانِي لَيْلًا, إِنْ أَتَانِي لَيْلًا قَبِلْتُهُ, if he comes to me in the darkness of the night, I will hold him close to me, I will accept his tawbah. وَإِنْ أَتَانِي نَهَارًا قَبِلْتُهُ, if he comes to me in the daytime, I will hold him tight, I will accept him. No matter what guna, no matter what sin, no matter what level of disobedience. وَإِنْ تَقَرَّبَ مِنِّي شِبْرًا تَقَرَّبْتُ مِنْهُ ذِرَاعًا, if he comes to me شِبْرًا, if he comes to me one hand span, I will come to my forearm's length. And if he comes to me ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتُ مِنْهُ بَعًا, if he comes to me in forearm's length, I will come to him in arm's length. وَإِنْ مَشَى إِلَيَّ هَرْوَلْتُ إِلَيْهِ, if he walks to me, I will come running to him. وَعَلَى خَالِقْ وَتَى رَزِقْ وَتَى مَالِقْ وَإِنْ إِسْتَغْفَرَنِي غَفَرْتُ لَهُ, if he asks me forgiveness, Allah make me maaf, I made a mistake, I will forgive him. وَإِنْ تَابَ إِلَيَّ تُبْتُ عَلَيْهِ, let him turn to me and see how I will turn to him. مَنْ أَعْظَمَ مِنِّي جُودًا وَكَرَمًا, who can be more generous, who can be more noble, who can be more honorable than Allah. وَأَنَا الْجَوَادُ الْكَرِيمُ عَبِيدِي, these are my servants. يَبِيتُونَ يُبَارِزُونَنِي بِالْعَظَائِمِ, they are bold enough to disobey me with so much disobedience and sins and ma'asiyat. وَأَنَا أَكْلَأُهُمْ فِي مَضَاجِئِهِمْ وَأَحْرُسُهُمْ عَلَى فُرُشِهِمْ, I am there on their beds, on their resting places, still to look after them and to protect them. مَنْ أَقْبَلَ إِلَيَّ تَلَقَّيْتُهُ مِنْ بَعِيدٍ, whoever turns towards me, I, no matter where they are, I will come to them to their aid. وَمَنْ تَرَكَ لِأَجْلِي, and whoever leaves guna, leaves ma'asiyat, leaves those platforms of zina, leaves those platforms of the violation and the disregard for the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَعْطَيْتُهُ فَوْقَ الْمَزِيدِ, I will give him more than he can imagine. Allah is telling the disobedient bandas, وَمَنْ تَصَرَّفَ بِحَوْلِي وَقُوَّتِي أَلَنْتُ لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ, and whoever trusts and qualifies to utilize my treasures, whoever administers my power, whoever becomes my banda, I will even soften lead for him. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ مُرَادِي, and whoever's desires comes to my desires, أَرَادْتُ مَا يُرِيدُ, I will make whatever he desires happen, I will make it all come through, whatever he is desiring, I will grant him that. These are my close servants, and these are my close bandas. Their desires will become my desires. Ahlu dhikri, ahlu mujalasati. Those that remember me constantly, they are my friends and companions. Wa ahlu shukri, and those that are grateful and show gratitude. Ahlu ziyadati, I will give them more bounties and ni'mas. Wa ahlu ta'ati, ahlu karamati, and those that obey me, I will honor and respect them. Wa ahlu ma'asiyati, and those that disobey me, la aqnituhum min rahmatihi, I will not deprive them of my mercy. In tabu ilayya fa ana habibuhum, and if they turn towards me, then I am their habib, I am their beloved. Wa illam yatubu fa ana tabibuhum, and if they don't make tawbah and they continue their guna, then I am their doctors. Abtalihim bil masaib, then I will test them, I will place trials, tribulations, calamities on their shoulders, so that I will cleanse them min al ma'ayib, from all the flaws, so that they meet me on the day of Qiyamah cleansed from all evils. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq of realizing the value of the short life and preparing for akhirah. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.